A Fox News alert breaking overnight. Suspects armed with automatic rifles drove up to the Dallas Police Department headquarters and opened fire. Brand new video from the ground shows officers now in a standoff with the suspect in a jack-in-the-box parking lot. They're currently negotiating and trying to convince him to surrender. But is growing anti-police rhetoric at all of this to partly to blame for the situation? Here to weigh in, a great panel of a Fox News contributor and radio host, David Webb, retired NYPD Lieutenant John Rafferty, and attorney Keisha Hebon. What a great group here to comment on a day like this. A lot of news going on today. But it really does get to the question of respect for authority. And this, it's a violent instance, but we've seen it as a cultural trend. And David, you've called it, you've had a lot, you've blamed a lot of things for helicopter parenting, other things. What's to the root of why this is happening?
The root is that, as I see it, we've lost a generation, one generation ago, that are now the helicopter parents raising a lot of children. But it goes beyond that because those parents work in our systems, in our institutions, and we've got a culture that's basically broken down where authority is not respected as much. And, you know, think of it in simple terms. Parents give kids boundaries. In the classroom, teachers give kids boundaries. Those boundaries are now being overshot because they feel there is nothing that someone can do about it. If your parents spank you, you call DPS or some social services, the parents are in trouble. No child ever died from spanking. They may have died from abuse, which is terrible, but a spanking never hurt a child and really did anything more than probably embarrass them. Beyond that, we have got too much of an establishment out there saying you're free to do whatever you want. We've got a free-range society where you can do whatever you want and there are no consequences. There are consequences in life to actions.
When fathers or mothers don't lay down actions, then why respect those authorities? And we see it from teenagers to youth. We also see with adults, with the pool party incident recently.
Right.
Keisha, your husband, you mentioned, is a cop.
Yes.
Had a particularly powerful anecdote about this. And what does it tell you about the respect for authority?
Well, I'm finding more and more, and so is he, that the youth do not respect or fear authority. And when I was growing up, we were taught you respect adults and especially police officers. And there was an incident where he and I met for lunch. He was in full uniform. We came out to go to my car, and there were three students sitting on the trunk of my car.
So not their car, your car.
Right, my car. And even though they knew it wasn't their car, and then we're walking towards the car, and they just sat there. They didn't care that there were two adults and a full uniform police officer coming. And he said, you know, you guys need to get off the car. And they talked back like, oh, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I can't believe that these kids didn't have the respect and the fear to say, you know what, I'm not supposed to be doing X, Y, and Z. And I think it's parenting as well. Like, parents are not teaching their children that you must respect authority.
Absolutely. And John, as a police officer yourself, have you seen that same sort of interaction from our youth? And has it changed over time? Have you seen any sort of a metamorphosis or from fellow members of the police force on how they've been treated? It's just, say, 10 years ago to how they're treated today.
I'll take it from the time I started in the police department. There was a mutual respect between the police and the community. For some reason now, we've seen that children every day, they're posting videos online, going after cops with videos, shoving cameras in their face. But I believe also it's the parents. I mean, if your child is on video and they're acting that way, you failed as a parent. You know, it's not just the child. The child learned that behavior somewhere. He learned that disrespect somewhere. It's not just his peers, but it's also the parents' job to instill what they should know, how to act as a civilized human being in this country.
Well, how does a police officer react to that? Because you can't play the role of parent. So, and in light of this criticism, many have been forced to pull back, and it makes it even more difficult.
What you see now is a lot of cops are pulling back. A lot of cops feel just because they have a camera shoved in their face, they're not doing what they should be doing. Just if we walk down the block, if I was just shoving a camera in your face, harassing you for no other reason, you could be arrested.
Sure.
I don't understand why these cops are being told not to arrest these people. We should be arresting them.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not serving a legitimate purpose, you're not allowed to do this to somebody. So why are we allowing it to be done to the police? I don't get it.
Sure. Well, we're taking away something important that you're getting to, which is the pillars of society approach. Policemen, pillars of society, they're part of your community. They are your community. They live there.
Right.
Also, you look at schools. They've taken away the ability of teachers to punish.
To discipline.
They take to discipline in schools. So if you take that away, the child doesn't have an effective home environment that gives them a better path to success as a young adult or an adult. And then they go to school and the teacher can't do anything about it. Then you have the police. What you're starting to see is this compendium of taking down the pillars of society.
I don't know what compendium means, but...
Body of evidence. But what's happening here is they're not being given any boundaries, and they grow up to be adults. So now they go to work. You go to work, and you're in your 20s, and you tell your boss, well, I don't care what you think. I'm entitled to this.
Mm-hmm.
You've built a society that literally doesn't know how to function. By the way, the worst part of this, in the long run, their own success is hampered in life. You're actually getting in the way of your own success.
Absolutely.
But real belief.
Okay, yeah. You know what? I think that the parents need to stop teaching their children that teachers and police officers are enemies. They're there to help us, and they keep us safe. So
that's important. Well, thank you for what your husband done. Thank you for what you do and for taking this stance. David Webb, John Rafferty, and Keisha Hebron, thank you very much for being here today.
Thank you.
Up next, the NAACP standing behind the leader who lied about her race.